Now we are going to discuss the motion analysis with uniform acceleration. So when a particle moves with uniform acceleration in rectilinear motion, we can simply state, say, when a particle moves at constant acceleration A and starts with initial velocity u. Say we are required to find velocity at the general time, you can simply state the velocity of particle after time t can be obtained as, we simply write acceleration as dv by dt. And here we can write dv is equals to adt. Now we integrate this expression. At t equal to 0, we can substitute the limit of velocity was u. In the beginning, it starts with initial velocity u, which was given. At a general time t, the velocity of particle say becomes v. Then on integration, left hand side will become v minus u. And on right hand side, we can say, as acceleration is constant, it can be taken out. And it becomes integration from 0 to t, though that will be just t. So velocity after time t can be written as u plus at. So you must be very careful about this equation. Equation number 1 we call first speed equation for constantly accelerated motion. For constant accelerated motion, we can directly use this expression which gives us velocity after time t if initial velocity is u. Further, if we are going to use the same expression, if we are given as v is equals to u plus at, we can simply write v as dx by dt, which is u plus at. And we can write dx is equals to u plus at into dt. This gives us the displacement travel in a duration dt. If we want to calculate the displacement after time t, so we can say initially when time was 0, the displacement was 0, when the particle was just started. And at general time t, particle will be at a position say s. And on integration, we'll get integration of dx, that will be s. And if we integrate u plus at, then u and a are constants, so it can be written as ut plus at square by 2. So this s is equals to ut plus half at square. This equation, which is equation number 2, this gives us the displacement covered by the particle in a time t if it is moving at constant acceleration a and with initial velocity u. This equation we term as second speed equation for uniformly accelerated motion. Let's discuss another equation, that is speed equation number 3 or third speed equation for uniformly accelerated motion. Similarly, if we use acceleration as v dv by dx, here we can write v dv is equals to a dx. On integrating this expression, say from a starting point where displacement was 0 and velocity was u, say after covering a displacement s, say velocity becomes v. Then on integrating, we'll get the final velocity after traveling the displacement s. So here it will be v square by 2 and we apply limits from u to v, and on right hand side we get a into s. So here left hand side will become v square minus u square by 2 is equals to as, or we can write v square is equals to u square plus 2as. Here, this equation gives us the velocity of particle after covering a displacement s if it was moving with a uniform acceleration a and with the initial speed it was started with u. This equation we write third speed equation for uniformly accelerated motion. Let's discuss the displacement of a particle during nth second for uniformly accelerated motion. Say for example, a particle starts from time t equal to 0 and is moving in a rectilinear motion. Say if we talk the time from t equal to 0 to t equal to 1 second, this we can call as first second of motion. From time t equals to 1 to t equal to 2, again the duration is 1 second, this we call second second of motion. Similarly, from t equals to 2 to t equals to 3, it is the third second of motion. Similarly, we can define different motions. If a particle starts with the initial speed u and it is accelerating with acceleration a, so we can say after every instant its velocity is gradually increasing. So as it is gradually increasing, we can state that later on, after starting, in 1 second duration, particle will cover more distance or displacement compared to the initial duration of 1 second. Say, we find out the displacement covered in nth second of motion. So, nth second of motion, if say particle cover a displacement delta Sn, it can be written as displacement covered up to n second minus displacement covered up to n minus 1 second. So, we just subtract the displacement up to n minus 1 second from the displacement which is covered up to nth second. So, it will give us the displacement delta S which is covered during nth second. Whereas, if we talk about nth second, so this is the time from t equals to n minus 1 to t equals to n. So, for calculation of this displacement covered in nth second, we are finding the displacement in n second and n minus 1 second and we are taking the difference. So, this can be easily calculated by speed equation number 2, that is ut plus half a t square. For nth second, we can write it un plus half an square minus, we subtracted the displacement up to n minus 1 second, this is u into n minus 1 plus half a into n minus 1 whole square. When we open this term, we'll get un plus half a n square, this is minus un plus u, then we are getting minus half a n square, then minus half a plus a n. So, here if you just carefully have a look on it, this half a n square gets cancelled out, this u n gets cancelled out, what will be left over is u plus, we can take half a common, this will be half a into 2 n minus 1. This is the relation used for calculation of displacement covered by the particle during nth second. This is also a quite important relation. So, just keep it in mind. In various problems, it is going to be used directly. Now, let's write down a note which will be extremely helpful for us to analyze speed equations in various problems. In this note, we are going to write all these speed equations are vector equations and the motion parameters like displacement, velocity, final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration are taken with appropriate signs according to the reference frame chosen. So, always be careful while applying the speed equations in various cases. These all are to be used as vector equations, as using these equations as vector equations will always be a beneficial way to handle a problem. And by this method, using this vector equations, we can also reduce the length of solution of a problem. Like if we talk about these equations, the first equation we use as V is equals to U plus AT. The second equation is S is UT plus half AT square. Third is V square is U square plus 2 A dot S. And the fourth, which we can use, we have just now derived, that is a displacement in nth second, that is U plus A by 2, 2N minus 1. So, be careful about these equations. In various cases, we are going to use these equations as vector equations.